This is a video about synchronizing the gyro. So normally in our tech logbook, we always write watch taken over and repeater synchronize. So this is the watch about how do you synchronize your repeaters, which all repeaters are there on bridge. If I want to show you from top, first repeater is this, second is this, or you can also call which is outside on bridge wing. So basically those are three repeaters. One repeater is inside this, which is on the autopilot. So one repeater is this, and there are other repeaters on the EGDIS, on the EGDIS and on the radars. So on radar also we have to make sure that the gyro heading is synchronized, and on EGDIS also we have to make sure your gyro heading is synchronized. So let's begin our video. First we'll start with synchronization of this autopilot repeater. This is my first repeater, which is in the autopilot itself. So as you can see, my gyro heading is 093.9, so almost 94. As it is not digital, so it cannot be corrected to 93.9, either 94 or 93. So we'll correct it to 94. First thing is, here is the repeater on or off. So this is on, but you can see my heading is as per this repeater is somewhere 89, so which is obviously wrong. So how will it synchronize this? Either you can use your nail or some coin or something to turn it off. Then you push this inside and move as you want. So now as you can see, I'm moving anti-clockwise. The dial is moving. The one important thing over here is, as you cannot see inside the fine precision of the numbering, so hence you have outside. It will give a good idea. So like 92 inside, it's 092, and it's matching over here 092. It's like this 092, and it's matching over here 092, because inside it's very hard to find out it's 92 or 93. So you can match it with the outside ring, this 90, this 12. So this is 92, and we have to go to, as you can see here, it is 94 gyro heading. So we will go for the, so you can see this inner circle, it is also moving 93. So and inside we are also having 93 94. Make sure that you have pressed this, release this. Okay, as you can see, this is 94. It gives you a good idea. 90 here, you can see the main reading 90, and here you can read the main the sub reading 94. As inside it's very hard to find out 1 2 3 4 like this. So it is 94. You can, with your nails, you can turn it on. So the now repeater is synchronized. Inside you can see it is 94. It's not 95. You might be thinking it's 95, it's the eye error. As you can see from here, it is 94 exactly. It is matching in the inner circle. So always make sure that you match with the inner circle, because the first circle inside, it's very hard to find out how much is the reading, 91 92. So you can compare with here. So 94, when you want to make it to 95, you can read the main reading 90 and then push this button and make it come to 95 over here. So this outer circle, basically this outer circle, the small circle, is good for correct. So this is synchronized. Now next thing is our gyro repeaters. This, so it is almost synchronized, as it is showing 94. So but if you still want to if there is a large difference and you want to synchronize this gyro repeater, you can see a spring over here. The spring over here, you have to push that to synchronize it. But before that, this is the on off button for synchronization. If you press it off, now the synchronization is not going on, and we have to press this spring and adjust. I'll show you how. If I press this spring, you can see this is the spring. So if I press this spring, and after pressing the spring, you have to turn it clockwise or anti-clockwise as the dial will move. So this is the spring. Now if I move it clockwise, you can see my dial pad is moving. I'll show. I'm moving clockwise. My card is moving clockwise. Now I'm moving anti-clockwise, my hand, and make sure the spring is pressed. Now if I release, just press and move clockwise, so it will move like this. Now I'm moving anti-clockwise. It is 93.9, so somewhere over here. Release your hand, and when you want to synchronize, just come over here, press on. So it is almost 94. You cannot synchronize 93.9. So just remember, you have to off from there, and this is the spring loaded push button. So you have to push this, and you have to move clockwise or anti-clockwise to synchronize. Another repeaters are present in ECDIS. So ECDIS, you can check 93.8. Okay, here also it is 93.8. So as we can see, the gyro is continuously synchronizing itself. We are actually at birth, but still, first I showed you it was 93.9, now it is 93.8. so you can know. The other one is this one, radar. As you can see, my heading is 93.9, but on my ECDIS it is 93.8, and on my gyro also it is 93.8. so how to synchronize this is, you come to menu. Some menu one, setting. You will find in your own radar, different type of radar have different settings. So it should be somewhere over here, and you have to press over here. So 93. Okay, release that. We have to do. So now it is 93.9. So okay, we'll press here 93. You can see here the values are changing, 93.9, and press enter. So it is 93.9. there also 93.9, on my gyro also it is 93. Let's check this radar. Here also it is 93.9, and the settings are same. If you want, now it's already synchronized, otherwise it would have been menu. So menu one, setting, and here you have to press here, click inside. I'm moving with my cursor, and just put the value, and you can press enter. Now I'm putting clear, exit. So as it was already saying, okay, so it is synchronized to 00, no problem, we'll synchronize it. It sometimes happens that your radars and gyro are different, so make sure to synchronize. This is synchronized, this is synchronized. Your ECDIS is this one, host recorder. Here I'll show you how to. Basically, my ship is stopped now, we are at berth, so it's easy to sync, make it to come to a proper heading. First, you have to see that there are four quadrant on the left hand side, and there are two dials. This one dial, which is always for the quadrant, and this dial is for the fine headings. So this one is for the first quadrant. This one is 0 to 90. This one 90 to 180. You can see 180 to 270. Third quadrant, fourth quadrant is 270 to 360. So my heading, as we have seen earlier, it is 94. So it lies under 90 to 180, this quadrant. Make sure, if you want to move this dial, you have to switch off the power and the repeater, because if the repeater is on, for example, let me show you. If my repeater is on, I cannot move the dial because it is synchronized with gyro, so it will not allow you to move. If the power is on, only the paper will not roll down. If the power is off, the paper will not roll down automatically, means we can lower it manually. As you can see, this is moving because the power is off. I can manually move my paper, it will not move automatically. And if we switch off the repeater, then we can move this dial and this dial. These two dials move simultaneously. As you can see, if I'm moving this, the other one will also move. Okay, when it will make a full round, the quadrant will shift, You can, now you will see. Okay, when now it will make a full round over here, the cotton will jump. You will see. So now it is 270 to 360. So let us begin with our heading. We have 94. So now this quadrant is in 0 to 90. It is in first quadrant. We have to go to second quadrant. So this is inside 90 to 180. And how we have to read is, you can see the readings inside the graph paper is like this: 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. But our heading is 94, so we have to come to the second one. As we have second quadrant, we have a second line over here, so it is increasing this side. The first line is increasing this side, the second line is increasing this side. 90 to 180 it will go like this, and 180 to the third line will be moving up, and the fourth line, this 270, it will be moving down. So it is like this. So now our heading is 94, our first quadrant is set. We just have to make sure the needle should pointing 94. So it is like 90. This is between 95. So it should match somewhere here. So our needle should match here. So as our power and repeater both are off, move this. You have to check how you have to move clockwise or anti-clockwise by moving right or left this wheel, the left wheel. And okay, as you can see, this pin is on. It is 95. It is at 94. I am reading the second line. Remember, I am reading the second line. 90, 91, 92, 93, 94. This is 94. This is 95. This is 100. So I am reading. You must not make a mistake reading the first line, because this is 85. If you are reading the first line, the second line, if you read, this is 94. So why we are reading the second line? Because our first needle is in the second quadrant. That is why. If it was in first quadrant, we would have been reading the first line. Second quadrant, second line. Simple. So this is 94. Over here, we have to match here 94. And it is matching over here. You can see over here this one 94. That's it. Our heading is matched. After matching the heading, press the repeater on, press the power on, that's it, finish. It will automatically move. Make sure these your paper holes are matching inside these grooves of the drums. And there are on the bottom also you will have drum grooves, and on the top also you will have them. So you can see.